What's up, Knights? Welcome back to this week's episode of The Studio.
On today's show, we take an insider's look at the new Chandler Art Museum, get a behind-the-scenes tour of Oregon Stop Pizza, and check out the boys' varsity basketball team.
All this and so much more as another episode of The Studio starts right now.
I've been seeing a lot of super sick travel videos lately. And when I came across this email, you know I had to tell my boy. Bro, we just got clearance to film at the Higley High School.
Bro, no way. The Kingdom?
Yes, bro. I'm serious. The Kingdom. Are you down?
Are you serious? Of course I'm down.
Okay, let's go get packed up. I'll pick you up in 10 minutes.
All right, let's go.
Hi, I'm David Clough.
And I'm Paris Merrill. Welcome to Higley High School's second most popular news broadcast.
Wait, what's the first one?
That's the joke. Get it? Because we're the only news broadcast. Right. Anyways, here at Higley, we display a lot of raw talent. Lindsay and Riley had a chat with Becky Mortensen about her passion for illustration.
Becky Mortensen is a senior at Higley with a special ability to portray her creativity through her artwork.
The first time I started painting was around fourth grade, so I've been painting for like 8 years. And I started when I was painting a picture of the ocean at the beach, and I just set out my paint and decided to paint the wave, and it turned out terrible, but I was really proud of it.
Throughout the many years she has been painting, she has learned to challenge herself using various tools.
My favorite paintings to do are mostly oil paints and landscape, but I also like challenging myself and doing portraits in like charcoal and other materials, because everybody knows that portraits are hard to draw.
Her passion for painting has allowed her to bond with friends while doing what she loves.
Me and my friends like to do Bob Ross painting parties, and that's super fun. And we also just set out paints and look on Pinterest for ideas and just do whatever we see that we want to paint.
Becky's many years of training has given her the opportunity to reach outside the Higley classroom and develop her talents through college courses.
I took all of the high school classes that art has to offer, which is like drawing, painting, beginning art, intermediate art, and AP studio art. So right now I'm at Chandler Gilbert taking a painting class, and that's fun because I get to work with artists who come from different backgrounds and are different levels in their artistic career. So I get to see and get inspired from what they have to share.
She plans on becoming a teacher to instill her love of art in others.
Right now I'm planning on going into art education so I can teach in the high school level, because that's one of my favorite things to do.
Art has had a tremendous effect on Becky's life.
I can't imagine what my life would be like without art, because you have the opportunity to create whatever you want in whatever way you can, and that's just a unique way to express yourself. No matter what you do with it, you can be individual and show what you have to offer to the world.
We look forward to seeing Becky's talents influencing her community and Higley High School.
This has been Riley Rohner
and Lindsay Simpson
reporting for
The Studio.
Next week, College Prep Club will be selling holiday grams during both lunches. Buy one for friends or staff and spread some holiday cheer.
Attention 10th and 11th graders. EVID applications for the 2019-2020 school year are now available in the counseling office. Once you have completed the application, please drop it off to the counselor, Mrs. Davis, so she can complete her section. Please do not take the application directly to EVIT. Students interested in the cosmetology or aesthetics classes need to make an appointment with Mrs. Davis to discuss the application requirements and deadline.
Higley Cheer and Palm competed in AIA Regionals last Saturday. Congrats to the cheer and stunt teams for qualifying for state for the first time ever. Thank you for working hard and representing Higley.
Aaron and Maverick went behind the scenes at Organ Stop Pizza to prove just how much organ music can truly enhance the pizza eating experience.
Hey Knights, the holiday season has finally arrived, and with many families celebrating this special time, Aaron and I set out to find a local restaurant that provided good food and even better entertainment. We visited Organ Stop Pizza, an Italian restaurant with a classical twist.
What makes Organ Stop different is that it's really family friendly because you are like surrounded by music and instruments. And once you walk in, you'll see like a huge organ and someone will be playing it every 30 minutes or so. And you can request any song you want and they'll play it if they know it.
One of the other things that makes it different from any other restaurant is that, you know, it's like going back in time to, you know, when a restaurant had sort of a family atmosphere to it. And, you know, this is like coming into a long-time family-owned restaurant where, you know, everyone knows everyone, and it's just kind of fun and wholesome.
We asked them what the best part of their Organ Stop experience was and got some insight on why people enjoy this place so much.
My favorite part is most of the pizza. The pizza is amazing. It's really better than any other pizza I've tried.
My favorite part about working here, probably think most people would expect me to say that it's playing the world's largest Wurlitzer pipe organ, which is a thrill, but really my favorite part about playing here is that people leave with a smile on their face. So it's one big party and you get to be a part of it.
I would say it's a perfect place for this holiday season because it's super family friendly. It's meant for all ages really. And you can just go there, have a great time, listen to music.
People should visit Organ Stop, of course, for food, but this is a very unique instrument that's here. And most people never have an opportunity to hear a theater organ unless they go into an old theater in the city somewhere. It's just, there's so much to see and hear. It's just, all of the senses are in play here.
Whether you come for dinner, dessert, or the entertainment, Organ Stop Pizza has you covered. It's located on the corner of Stapley and Southern. Be sure to check it out if you're ever in the Mesa area. Reporting for the studio, this is Maverick Wolf and Aaron Schmidt.
Buddy Prom was on Saturday the 24th, and it was a huge success. Thanks to everyone who came out to the dance.
Congratulations to our Higley Knights wrestling team for taking third place at the Quest for the Crown tournament this past weekend. Be sure to follow the team on Twitter at Higley Wrestling.
This past weekend, the Power Ranch Barn held a Holiday Blitz Boutique, showcasing an array of different Christmas vendors, as well as other holiday booths. Paris and Olivia snagged the footage for us live from the event.
The holiday season really is one of the best times of the year. Paris and I decided to come out to Holiday Bliss Boutique in Power Ranch to see what the vendors had to offer.
I'm Tiffany Bellows. I'm an independent pro for Damsel in Defense.
So my name is Kathy Crow, and my business is Crow's Creations. And I sell all kinds of home decor and holiday decor.
My name is Jennifer Bussell, and I am here today selling painted rock art. The title we have today is Creative Cacti.
So we sell a variety of different items. There's items, self-protection items for women and children. So the stun gun is the most popular for women, and for children, it's probably the books or the board game.
The most popular item are the large and the small cacti pots.
I think the wine glasses are a big item that I sell. I like to add the glitter to it.
Many people come to the market for the products and atmosphere, but keep coming back because of the wonderful community.
You know what? I love this market. This is, like I said, my second year here, and I love the community of the Power Ranch, and I just think it's a fun community that people all come together and everything, and I meet the best people here.
I feel like it has a more homey vibe to it. You know, it's in this community, so families can come. It's a great atmosphere.
These vendors share with us why they love what they do.
I think it's just meeting the people and just doing it. My first big season was this season, and so like for the last 3 weeks, I was at these big boutiques that I've sold out of stuff.
My favorite memory is sitting around with my aunts and cousins and even my daughter and just painting and laughing and having a great time.
The Holiday Bliss Boutique truly is a wonderful place to come with your family and friends. Make sure to come out here next year. This has been Paris and Olivia reporting for the studio.
Our nation's schools are full of students who possess a desire to go to college and the willingness to work hard, but many of them may not be prepared for the college and career path ahead of them. The AVID program on our campus is designed to help students succeed on their road to college and career success. For those wondering if they too should attend college, we recently sat down with Coach Meyer to find out what attending college did for him.
College has benefited me by giving me the tools I need to have a career, basically, right? After you get through all the boring stuff, the first part of college I wasn't really a fan of. You had to do a lot of the same stuff you did in high school, but then when you finally get into those more hands-on classes, that's where it really you meet other like-minded people, and so that just kind of helps fuel your professional fire. It really set the foundation, so when I did get that first job, I wasn't as nervous as I thought I'd be. I got to just hit the ground running, basically.
Dude, over the weekend, I went to this sick place.
Really?
Yeah, it's got like graffiti everywhere, and there's a ton of places to eat.
Graffiti? What's this place called?
The Chandler Art Museum.
Oh, well, let's check it out then.
Attention Knights, the Chandler Museum is opening several new, fun, and educational exhibits. I was invited to check out everything the museum has to offer days before the grand opening to promote these exciting new displays.
Hi, my name is Lizzie Olson. I am Visitor Services here at the Chandler Museum, and I work at the front desk.
I'm Nate Myers. I'm the Curator of Collections here at the Chandler Museum. So as the Curator of Collections here at the Chandler Museum, I deal with all the stuff. That's the artifacts that come in. That includes stuff like paintings or furniture.
One of the many areas at the Chandler Art Museum is the Awkward Family Photos exhibit. This new exhibit shows off real and hilarious family photos, and some even have their backstory.
You can also come in and visit our traveling exhibit, Awkward Family Photos, which is what I'm standing in now. And also you can submit an awkward photo of you and your family. And then we'll have a digital frame that was going to be running a slideshow of our local submissions.
Along with hilarious, awkward family photos, the Chandler Museum is also offering a chance to look back on history.
The second exhibit that we're opening with on the 8th is called Gaman, and it's about the Japanese-American internment camp.
During World War II, there was a Japanese-American internment camp not far from Chandler. And one of the programs that was tied to that was really successful and that we're really proud of is a project to fold 16,655 origami cranes, one for each person who was incarcerated at Gila River during World War II.
If you're wondering how, when, or where to go for more information, Lizzie has your answer.
Our opening day is December 8th. 2018, and then the museum will be open from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. that day.
So remember, Knights, be sure to visit the Chandler Museum tomorrow on Saturday. This has been David and Andrew signing out for The Studio.
The Air Force Junior ROTC Drill Team took overall grand champion at the Desert Talon Drill Meet. The team beat 14 other schools from across the Phoenix region. They also placed first, second, and third from multiple groups. A final congrats goes to Cadet Christian Nichols, who took second place overall in the Armed Drill Down competition.
The girls' varsity soccer team took on the Eagles of Ironwood last Friday, defeating them with a score of 11-0. Congratulations to Haley Gilliam and Maya Stice for scoring a combined total of 7 goals. Come out at 6 p.m. tonight to watch your Lady Knights take on the Ironwood Ridge Nighthawks.
Mr. Nettle's video production classes recently completed a music video project in which their students were required to choose a song for which they would produce a shot list and a storyboard. They were then required to execute their shots on set and edit the footage into a finished music video. The following clip shows the video expertise demonstrated by sophomore Lacey Wolbrink.
Congratulations to Asia Northern on taking first place at the Royal Lady Wrestling Tournament this weekend. Great job and keep up the great work.
Congratulations to Rebecca Damo and Juliana DeBato for being selected to represent Higley High School this summer at the Hugh O'Brien Youth Leadership Seminar. The 3 to 4 day seminars empower students to cultivate their leadership skills through interactive workshops to become effective ethical leaders in their home, school, and community. They discover how personal group and societal leadership leads to social change.
In past years, Higley basketball has had a lot of great moments on the court. But with some new changes to the team this season, they've found a way to improve even more. Here's Ethan and Cameron, who caught up with this year's varsity basketball team.
It's basketball season again, Knights, and I'm sure that some of you are wondering how this season is going to go. Ethan and I caught up with some of our varsity basketball players to see what's in store and what's changed for this year.
Well, a lot's changed. We only have 3 kids from the team last year, so it's basically a whole new team, but we have a lot better chemistry this year, and we're hoping to build off of that.
At practice, we work a lot on shooting, conditioning, and we go over the plays that we run in the game so that we can be able to execute when we need them.
Well, some of the challenges that we'll be facing this year is a lot of inexperience because we don't have a lot of kids from the team last year. So we're going to have to build on that and become more of a team and work together to improve. Well, last year's season we had a lot of success at times, and we're hoping to build off of that even though we don't have the exact same team.
I think we work hard and play good defense and just move the ball well that we'll be able to be successful this year.
I think the best approach for the season ahead is to work as a team so we can play our best basketball. My favorite part about playing basketball is being a part of a team and being able to make friendships along with that.
This year we're looking to have a good season, so everyone come out and support us at home. And yeah, go Knights.
Be sure to come out to all of the basketball games this season and get crazy in the student section. This is Cameron and Ethan signing off for the studio.
That just about wraps up our show for today, Knights.
Until next time, see ya!
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at the Studio HHS.